Lep pozdrav še z komentatorskega mesta, ljubiteljice in ljubitelji slovenskega nogometa. Četrti krog prve lige Telemach in derbi ljubljanske kotline Domžale Olimpija. Tekma, ki je pred nami, tekma dveh ekip na povsem različnih koncih lestvice prve lige Telemach. Ljubljančani so izvrstno začeli sezono, ne samo doma, ampak tudi v Evropi, kjer si utirajo celo pot proti velikemu cilju, to je konferenčni ligi. Diogo Pinto napada za Olimpijo, Motika. V zadnjem času zelo razpoložen Motika. Le morda žele celo malce preveč. Sam je zaključil z težkega položaja. Toni Gobec iz Bistrice in pa Rok Vodišek tudi kot dodatna moč med vratnicama. Priložnost za Olimpijo, Brest, Durdovi gol! In pa ne bo veljal. 18. minuta, Durdov je pospravil žogo v mrežo Domžal. Shamrock Rovers 1-0. Brest zdaj napada za Olimpijo. Žorž Silva, premočna podaja za Durdova, potem pa napaka v domžalski obrambi. Motika! Z ravno nevarnimi situacijami za Vidoška, ki je enkrat ujel podajo Perca v kazenski prostor, to pa je to. Silva na drugi strani, Silva pred vrata, Brest, Talisson, priložno za Motiko zdaj, to da ni zadela Olimpija. Zdaj je Šturm mimo Ratnika, Ratnik je tule izpadel. En Ristić je na koncu v zadnjem trenutku izbil pred Kolobaričem. Tem znova vodijo, kaj pa Olimpija, podaja v kazenski prostor, Lasickas! Zelo blizu je bil Justas Lasickas. Ole je bila, mislim, da kar najlepša priložnost Olimpije v drugem polčasu. Stavili so napad Ljubljančani, Motika. Pa Suale pred vrata, priložnost in mimo gola. Tokrat je Pedro Lucas zgrešil celo žogo po podaji Sualeja.
Erik, verjetno, če bi vam pred tekmo ponudili točko proti močni Olimpiji, v tej sezoni bi jo zagotovo vzeli. Potem pa pogledamo drugi polčas, v katerem ste po menjavah, katere so bile vzpodbudne, zagrali tudi napadalne, imeli neke priložnosti, neke situacije, ki bi se lahko končali drugače, ste morda pričakovali še kaj več?
Pa ja, mi smo že pred tekmo vedeli, da bomo trpeli, da je Olimpija zelo kakovostna ekipa, to je to danes dokazala, ampak so res fanti vsi, te, ki so igrali, te, ki so prišli iz klubce, tudi te, ki so ostali na klub in na tribuni, so pač dali maksimum svoj, na koncu nas je to nagradili s točko, ja, malo sreče, če bi bilo, bi mogoče tudi kakšna žoga končala v mreži, tudi na njihovi strani. Tako da jaz mislim, da na koncu, glede na prikaz, mislim, da z naše strani zaslužena točka.
Kaj ste dejali fantom, glede na to, da je to prva točka v sezoni, verjetno proti vsaj zaenkrat najtežjemu nasprotniku in glede na to, da vam tudi na papirju naslednji nasprotniki malce bolj odgovarjajo, čeprav ni lahkih nasprotnikov v prvi ligi Telemach?
Ja, tako zdaj prva dva kroga smo, kako smo že pretekli, da smo pač sami pre sebi videli, da bi se mogoče malo zaslužili več. Zdaj ta zadnja tekma z Radomljami sem rekel, da sem kar se tiče pristopa, da je bilo res pod nivojem, ampak smo čez teden vedeli, čutili, da lahko. Fantje so res dobro trenirali, treniramo že skozi dobro, ampak na koncu smo vedeli, da nas enkrat mora nagraditi, ker na treningu dajemo maksimum, tako da danes je prišla ta, mislim, da zaslužena točka.
Kaj pa ste jim dejali v slačilnici po tekmi?
Da mora biti vsako tekmo tako, da moramo pač iti na maksimum, včasih požreti ta ego, ki se nabere v grlu, ga požreti, išče sebe in te na koncu nogomet nagradi.
If you are not able to score, so it's impossible to win. That was our target, to come here to win. We made a good first half till the final third. In the final third, we didn't have the aggressiveness that is needed to score. That was the point we talked mainly in the half time. I think we came into the second half very good, also being dominant the signal in the first, creating chances, but of course when the game is open in the second half they had some options because we were also trying to approach more the final third. But the resume is that you don't score, okay. Normally we think that risk that we came here to play, to try to score. The other team doesn't want to play, only wait for something to happen, losing time all the time, and they had some moments because we are risking, but no problem. This kind of game, we know that we have to play sometimes, and if we score, it is done, the job, but we weren't able to score.
During the halftime, you made three changes. Were they all tactical, or were there any small injuries, considering you are in a very hard rhythm of games?
No, more or less, we have in the plan to split the minutes for the players that they are playing more. Also, Aki had one yellow card. Center back with this situation always is this. And George had a problem in one finger. I think he came to the hospital to make some tests. But we had in advance in our mind to split minutes, so it's okay. No, not any problem with this.
Just for the last thing, even though you drew, the fans were amazing here today. They at the end of the game, they said that they expect a win against Sheriff during the week, which would prolong your European season. Are you planning to oblige them?
Of course, we thank them, all the support they are bringing to us, and we are happy to feel that they are happy. They are feeling that the team is playing good football, is fighting. It's a fighting spirit team. Also, it's a team that want to be dominant and with personality in the games. So I think that the fans, they like this. And also we like a lot that they support us.
Na koncu, verjetno, če bi vam pred tekmo ponudili, da dobite točko proti izjemno močni Olimpiji v tej sezoni, bi verjetno podpisali, ampak v drugem polčasu, v nekaterih delih tekme, pa se lahko morda vprašate, da bi lahko vzeli nekaj več.
Ja, že pred tekmo smo vedeli, da dobro delamo že dolge tri tedne in da nas bo enkrat mogel nagraditi. Na tekmi smo trdo garali, v obrambi delali smo en za drugega, res čestitke vsem fantom, zahvalil bi se tudi trenerju za priložnost, glede na to, da sem mlajši igralec. In v drugem polčasu smo imeli določene priložnosti, po priložnosti lahko bi boljši izkoristili, ampak mislim, da moramo biti s točko zadovoljni.
Pa je verjetno tudi ta točka neka spodbuda za nadaljevanje sezone. Ne bom dejal, da so lahki nasprotniki v slovenski ligi, ampak na papirju vendarle nekoliko ugodnejši spored v naslednjih tednih za vas, da naberete večje število točk in se tudi spustite po lestvici navzgor.
Ja, seveda. Olimpija je trenutno v zelo dobri formi, tudi v Evropi nizajo dobre rezultate in na doseči tako točko je zelo dobro, kajti dvigne se ti samo zavest in z dobro popotnico gremo na naslednje tekme, ki so za nas zelo pomembne.
Peter, first time Olimpija didn't win under the new coach in this season. There were hard conditions, it was very hot, but it feels like you left the win in the first half. In the second half, Domžale were way more equal than you. Do you agree?
Well, in the first half we dominated, you know, no doubt. In the second half, they have some little bit of chances, but like also, we also dominated the game. We just unlucky. We didn't use like the chances we had, you know, so yeah.
What is the reason behind this? Maybe the hard rhythm you are playing at the moment, because you're playing during the weekend and during the week as well?
Well, I'm not going to give excuses to as to why we drew this game with Domžale, because like we had every chances to win the game. We dominated the game, I think, but like we didn't take our chances. So I don't want to say because of we play like a lot of games, you know, but like I think we can win this game even with because from the game, if you watch, you know, everything, we had the chance, we dominated, so that's it, you know.